गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन, हैव ए नाइस डे, सिट डाउन। टुडे विल डिस्कस कंडीशनल, डू नो कंडीशनल सेंटेंस, एनीबॉडी? कंडीशन, इफ इट रेन्स I shall not go to your house. Condition. If you success in the examination, I will award you. Condition. If I were the Prime Minister of India, you will be my private secretary. Condition. We'll go back little bit about the sentence. Have you read sentence? Yes or no? Define sentence. Boys, no? Boys only making noise and shouting, talking, going, coming, this like, not to answer. Soumya. On the roof of the house. Group of what?
But sir, it doesn't make sense.
Why not? Now on the roof of the, on the top of the roof, sense is there.
Sir, sentence is a group of words which make a complete sense.
On the top of the roof. In the garden. The sentence. So? A group of words have subject and verb. What you told, that is a phrase. Phrase, a group of words having meaning but not complete meaning. A sentence, group of words with subject and verb and ends with an appropriate punctuation mark. Maybe exclamation or full stop or interrogative marks. Without subject verb, a sentence cannot be formed. You know, there are generally four sentences we have read: assertive, interrogative, imperative, exclamatory. Declarative is known as assertive. Assertive sentence is known as declarative. Simple sentence you may call it. Four sentences you know. After four, again two sentences are there. Fifth one is optative. Sixth one is conditional. Okay, you know four sentences: assertive, or you may call it declarative. Before going to conditional, I am teaching this one. Number two is called interrogative. Number three is known as imperative. Okay. Number four is known as exclamatory. Number fifth is known as optative. Number sixth is known as conditional. We know these first four and last two. Last two, I think you don't know. Last two, optative and this assertive, no? Assertive declarative, a sentence that tells something, declares something, express something is called assertive. Interrogative, you know?
Which asks questions.
Ask questions, ends with interrogative mark, question mark, interrogative. Imperative, you know? It tells orders, commands, instructions, suggestions, requests, advice, imperative. Exclamation is strong feeling, idea, wonderful feeling, idea, or astonish, surprise things, that is called exclamatory. Optative tells about wishings. May God bless you, may you success in the examination, may the king long live, like this. Conditional, as example I have told you conditionals. So every sentence divided into two parts, negative and interrogative. Introit sentence having two. One is yes no question, another is WH question. Yes no questions begins with auxiliary verb. And we get the answer with yes and no. Example, are you Indira Gandhi?
No, sir.
Answer is no. Have you eaten?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So when we get the answer by yes or no and the sentence begins with auxiliary verb is known as yes or no. Double H question, we don't know answer. We search for it, isn't it? Suppose I am telling, what is your name?
My name is
Varsha. We don't know your name. I am asking for a complete answers. Are you Varsha?
Yes.
Yes. That is yes or no questions. We get the answer. Okay. The difference with the question begins with WH word, like who, what, whose, which, where, how, whatever it may be. Begins with WH word, ends with a question mark. And we answer want to get in a complete sense is called double H questions. Okay. Imperative giving orders, expressions of suggestions, advice, command, instructions, polite request, go there, do this work, please help me, stand up, don't talk, help the poor, don't waste time. Imperative. Okay. Exclamatory, what a beautiful girl flying in the sky. Astonished, strong feeling, strong idea. The old man died. Wah, we win the match. Hip hip hooray. Shh, PK's house is coming. Astonished, strong feelings. Optative, wishings. As I told you, conditionals, very important in your subjects, conditional. We come to the conditional now, the sixth part we have to teach. Okay, if there is conditions, that's a conditional sentence. We want to express our view in three ways, conditional sentence. One is probable, improbable, impossible. Probable means what? You know? Or perhaps. Improbable. Impossible. Conditional sentence has been divided into three broad divisions. One is probable. We may call it open condition and unfulfilled condition of the present time and unfulfilled condition of the past. We may call it open or zero conditional. Unfulfilled condition of the present, unfulfilled condition of the past. Probable, first coming, understood synonym, open condition or we may call it zero conditions. It may be or may not be. Okay. Suppose I am telling C, it may rain, it can rain, it must rain, it rain. Different answer, no? It rains means it is open condition if you put it if. If it rains, open condition, zero conditions. If it rains, I shall not go to school. If it rains, my birthday party will be cancelled. No, no. If it rains, our examination can be forfeited. If it rains, I will dance in the rain. Open conditions. Second and C, it is probable. Isn't it? It is probable. Here, may means negative sense. You see, when you see the TV or radio, the news, puttling, it may be rain is there. They never tell, it must be rain, never. Telling, it may be negative sense. Here, possibility come, it can, possibility. Here, nobody can break, definitely. The difference you, if it rains, open conditions, possibility zero, negative sense, positive sense, sure certainty, 100%. So, in the probable conditional sentence, first one, open probability, which is will be definitely or indefinitely chance is theirs. Means it is according to our labor. If I were the CM of Odisha, open conditions, without examination, you all pass. Second, understood, first condition, probable, understood, no, first probable. Improbable, unfulfilled condition of the present, improbable. How? Tell, who can tell? How it is improbable conditions, who can tell? Which one? Improbable. If a ghost appeared in your class, what happened? All would run away or embrace him. If a ghost appeared, will embrace him? All run away. Improbable, it cannot be happen. Is it in the present? We are talking in the present time. Yes or no? If our principal remains absent today, our class will be suspended. Improbable, never. Principal absent, what happened? Vice principal is there. Other teachers are there. Isn't it? Again, if Dhruti Pagya remains present today, others will not come to school. Improbable. She will come. What happened to others? Isn't it? If Samya cries in the night, dreams will be fainted away. Impossible, improbable, is it not? Samya cry, what happened to others? Dreams will come. So improbable means we are talking about the present tense, present conditions. What is going to happen? Understood? Zero conditions, we can compare everything open. Then impossible means? Past tense. Suppose I will tell, if I did hard labor, I would have passed in the examination. Exam result completed. Exam result published. I am thinking now about my labor. Is it possible? That kind of things, if I have to realize in the second, then it can be possible. Or in the first, it's okay. If you do hard labor, you must succeed in the examinations, open condition. If you do hard labor, you must succeed in the examination, open labor, open conditions, probable conditions. If you don't do hard labor, you cannot. Wait, improbable, present conditions, indeed. And in impossible what? That is? Past habit. If I had wings, I would have fly in the sky. Impossible. the horses have, if the horses were wings, they would fly in the sky. Impossible, isn't it? So there are three conditions there. One is a probable open condition, improbable unfulfilled condition in the present time, impossible unfulfilled condition in the past times. These things we have already, the time gone, we are thinking now, can't be recovered. This is unfulfilled present time, can't be possible. Open condition ho sakta hai, maybe. Okay, so these are very basic importance of the conditional sentence, probable, improbable, impossible. All have understood?
Yes, sir.
Thank you all. With this, today's class completed.